Hi, I'm Pierre Brio, and I'll be talking about improving support miners Ronk attacks applications to James and Rainbow. This is joint work with John Baena, Daniel Kabarkas, Rail Perner, Daniel Smith-Toney, and Javier Verbel. James and Rainbow are multivariate signature schemes. This means that they rely on multivariate maps. So James was selected as an alternate candidate to the third round of the NIST post-quantum competition, and it relies on the HFE central map. So HFE is one of the oldest multivariate schemes, which was invented in 1996. So now Rainbow is a finalist to the same competition, and it is based on another type of construction, which is called UOV. So even though those two constructions are quite different, both schemes are vulnerable to what we call Ronk attack. A Ronk attack is a particular type of key recovery attack by solving an instance of the min-Ronk problem. So in min-Ronk, you're given a set of public matrices M1 to MK over FQ, and your goal is to find a Ronk D linear combinations whose coefficients X size may lie in L, which is an extension field of FQ. So recently, a breakthrough on this problem was the introduction of support miners, which is a new algebraic modeling, which is usually solved using linearization techniques. So independently, there were also some weaker min-Ronk instances which were proposed to attack these NIST candidates, and in particular this last work by Tao, Peljold, and Ding presented at Crypto last year, which aims at attacking HFE variants by proposing a new min-Ronk problem. So a first contribution was trying to propose a similar attack on HFE variants by using the same min-Ronk instance as in Tao et al, but this time we use support miners. So a difficulty to use this modeling was that this min-Ronk problem has too many solutions, and these solutions directly come from the extension field structure FQN, which is used in HFE. And in particular, it was clearly impossible to perform the initial linearization technique on the support miner system. A second contribution was trying to analyze the memory complexity of a support miner attack on min-Ronk. So clearly, more generally, memory usage can be a bottleneck for algebraic attacks because we deal with linear algebra operations over very large matrices. And actually, in the case of algebraic attacks, this memory cost, this memory access, may highly depend on the input polynomials. And what we show is that we can exploit the support miner structure in order to come up with a more precise complexity estimation. And for that, what we do is we give a memory management strategy which is adapted to this support miner structure, and in which most memory accesses may become local. So here you can see the effects of our new attack on HFE variants on James. So even though the James scheme was already quite affected by the attack by Tao et al, our attack breaks the scheme even more, and also it makes that further attempt to repair the scheme, either by increasing the size of the parameters or by proposing new modifiers, would be clearly impractical. So for our second contribution, we present its impact on the regular min-Ronk attack by Belens. So in this case, there are also some P equations which depend on the Rainbow public key, which are added to the support miner system. And finally, we present the cost of this attack on Rainbow parameters, and contrary to previous estimations which don't take the structure into account, we show that this attack may indeed reduce the security of the scheme. So thank you for your estimation, and don't hesitate to have a look either at the paper or to attend to the live talk.